The next definition that we have learned is scarcity definition of economics by Lionel Robbins. Now in the definition we have studied that he tries to, or in the subject, in the definition, he tried to mention that economics deals with the human behavior, where it has been human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means. Now if you follow that, we come to certain features what he tried to highlight in that definition. What is that? Number one, unlimited wants. Unlimited wants. If you consider human wants, just you think yourself how many types of desires, how many types of wants you have. Quite a number. Now if you consider the sum total of the wants of all the people of a say closed economy, or closed economy in the sense in your neighborhood. Now if you think of the nation, the total population of a nation, of an economy as a whole, then all people, if their wants are accumulated, considered, and from the nation, if you talk about the entire globe, then the considered the number of wants, number of desires, number of ends to be fulfilled in the economy, they are quite, we can say they are unlimited. And not only unlimited, it is not one time. Our wants are growing over time. So wants are not only unlimited, but they are growing over time. So unlimited human wants, or unlimited wants in the economy that he mentioned. Now to satisfy those wants, you need resources. You need them to be produced. If you want to satisfy human wants, they need to be produced. To produce, you need resources. But resources in the economy are limited. You can't have uncounted labor supply. You can't have abundant or unlimited capital resources. So there are resources, but resources are limited. Limited in the sense, limited means scarce. Scarce refers to the word limited. Limited means refers to limited, sorry, scarce means refers to limited resources. Okay, alternative uses of means. Now these resources or means, they have alternative uses. You can put one capital in production of one good, or the capital in the production of another good. You can use labor in the production of one good, or you can use labor in the production of another good. Where to employ, because these means have alternative resources, alternative uses. So where to use them, that is important. So you have to consider priority. So there comes the problem of choice. See, one-to-one linked. Okay, there comes the problem of choice. You have to choose where the resources can be best employed according to the wants, according to the, to fulfill the priority needs, urgent needs, priority needs. So the problem of choice comes into action, or that also is a part of study of economics. And finally, it has been, he told economics as a science. Why science? Because to solve in a situation like this, where wants are unlimited, where there are scarce resources, and that those resources having alternative uses, they need to be properly chosen and employed for production of definite goods. Okay, they need something, laws, formulas to be adopted so that the optimum use of the resources can be done. The optimum use of resources can be done, and the goods can be produced for the proper distribution in the economy. So when all these formulations, all these theories coming up with the implementation of the resources and welfare of the people, distributing them in the economy, the goods being produced, that's your problem, solving the problem of choice, what is to be produced. Okay, when these things are coming up, you need proper formulation, you need proper theories. For that, economics has been considered as science. Okay, so these were the features that the definition of Lionel Robbins's considered. Now, coming to the criticisms part, now definitely few things have not been considered or few things have been mentioned. What are the criticisms we talked about? The three significant criticisms we are talking here. Number one, see, a narrow view. It has been criticized by other economists that Robbins's definition definitely considered a lot of things, but few things were missing. There was a narrow view in the economics in the sense he has considered. See, economics can be considered in two ways. One is positive economics, one is normative economics. Positive economics refers to what is the fact, what is present. But if you talk about normative economics, it gives stress on what ought to be, means it refers to what should be for any particular economic activity, what should be the best thing to come out. His definition did not consider this normative aspect. He is considered only talked about the positive aspect of economics. Okay, restricted subject matter. His definition, if you consider again, if you go to the definition once again, unlimited ones, limited resources, how they can be put into uses. There was no consideration of employment. There was no consideration of price. Different things which comes in the economy as it comes into force, the subject comes into force. There are certain subjects, no consideration about employment, no consideration about price, no consideration about say different market aspects in the market, behaviors, okay, those things have not been considered in his definition. And his definition is considered static. It did not speak about the future generation. Future generation in the sense, economics in future, the problems which are there or the features of in the subject what has been mentioned is for the present economic situation. What will happen? Those who criticize tried to refer that the economic growth part, the development part or the growth part has not been considered. So his definition is also considered as static. So these are the significant criticisms. Please study them nicely. Try to get the concepts, what the definitions. Now see, we have a lot of points to say. You may have different views to say, but we are restricted to the definition, features and criticisms of those specific eminent economists who gave the subject different dimensions as the time progressed. As there is evolution of the subject from starting from 19th century and from 1930s, then 1900, 1930s up to the 1960s, 70s, 80s, different theories came up. So with the progress of the subject, how different economists has specified the definition of economics, its features and criticisms, we are restricted to that. So please go through them, listen to the explanations carefully, read the text, and then you have to copy it down or write it down in your classwork exercise books.